President Uhuru Kenyatta yesterday vowed to continue with the war against corruption and impunity and urged the public to join in apprehending perpetrators. The president said he is ready to lose friends and allies and warned that no one will be spared, however powerful or wealthy. "I have lost close friends over the war on corruption. We must be ready to lose friends and do what is right in the eyes of God," Uhuru said when he addressed congregants during a service at the Faith Evangelistic Ministry Church in Karen. He said the country stands on a threshold of transformation and said, "If we fail to fight impunity, we will not achieve our dreams. A time has come for us to fight impunity, no matter how powerful you are, which high office you hold, how much wealth you have, or how many people you know in high positions. That will not save you," Uhuru said. Last week, the government partially demolished multi-billion shilling buildings including Southend Mall, UKI Centre, a petrol station and convenience store that were built on riparian land. As many as 4,000 properties are marked for demolition in the operation by the multi-agency Nairobi City Regeneration Team to save the Nairobi River. It is not clear how long the demolitions will take and their cost. Owners are expected to bear part of the cost. Uhuru also announced that officers who approved construction of the illegal buildings should be arrested and charged. Riparian land is public and it is illegal to build there. The Office of the Director of Prosecutions promptly directed the DCI to set up a desk at the police headquarters where complainants can file details of the requisite approvals for the illegal buildings. The president said those calling him were wondering how he could remain silent and watch buildings worth billions being brought down. "We must fight impunity not because we want to destroy for the sake of it. If we do not fight impunity, we will not achieve our goals. For the country to succeed, we must fight corruption and impunity," the president said. "Let's develop a nation that has a conscience and one that is driven by God-fearing people," the president told worshippers. He added, "We must begin to judge people by their character and reward them on the basis of what they have achieved for the country, their talents and skills," he added.